Hi friends, today it's put President Coriolanus Snow from the Hunger Games into the spotlight. President Snow is the man in charge of Panem throughout the majority of this series, and he uses threats and poison to get his way.
You should imagine thousands upon thousands of your people dead.
His full name, as mentioned earlier, is Coriolanus Snow. Coriolanus is the name of a character from a Shakespearean play that's based on a Roman legend. The legend tells the story of Gaius Marcius, a Roman general who lived in approximately 5th century BC. He led a siege against the city Corioli that he won, and he was therefore given the nickname Coriolanus. After his victory, he decided to join the political ranks of Rome. He became a very ambitious and ruthless politician, which eventually led to his downfall. This obviously really mirrors the president that we see in the Hunger Games series. He rose to power by killing his opposition and ended up losing his presidency and his life due to a rebellion. His last name, Snow, is obviously linked to the weather, snow. Snow is beautiful and alluring to many, but extremely dangerous and potentially lethal if you're not careful. Much like how the president doesn't actually at first seem dangerous, it's only once you get to know him or you know his personality that you realize he is a lethal person.
If you refuse, I kill someone you love.
Similarly, Snow, the weather type, is extremely cold, much like the president. Lastly, and probably most importantly, Snow is the opposite of fire. Snow is damp, cold, and white, whereas fire is dry, hot, and colorful. This parallel is mirrored perfectly in the series, with President Snow fighting Katniss, the girl on fire. Snow's physical description in the books and how he appears in the movies are quite different. In the books, he's described as being a small, thin man with white hair and tight, stretched lips. Though it's not confirmed, many citizens believe that his lips have undergone some kind of surgical procedure to make them appear fuller. It's gotten to the point that his lips are grotesque and tight and look just really creepy. However, in the movies, we see that he's of average height and weight. And though his hair is white, his lips don't seem to have undergone any kind of cosmetic procedure.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Though not much has changed about the character for the movies, we do just see a lot more of him. Bear in mind, the books are written in Katniss's perspective, so we only see President Snow when she's with him. However, the movies are more of an external perception, so we do see President Snow even if Katniss isn't there.
She shot an arrow at your head.
Well, at an apple.
Near your head.
This helps the audience get a better insight on this character. We see him openly and very clearly threaten Seneca Crane, his head game maker.
I like you. Be careful.
This shows the audience just how ruthless he is and that he doesn't care about other people's lives. He will very easily kill anybody who goes against him or even who just doesn't go in his direction. For Snow, if you're not with him, you're against him, and if you're against him, you need to die. We also see a lot of his interactions with Plutarch, which show us just how paranoid he actually is.
So fear. More fear.
It won't work. Fear does not work as long as they have hope.
Snow definitely seems out of his depth and almost out of control at times due to the stress of the potential rebellion. This is a side of Snow we don't really see in the books. His conversations with Plutarch also show that he's not that big of a mastermind and he's not a very good judge of character. Plutarch spends weeks, maybe even months, lying to Snow's face without Snow realizing that he's actually part of the Rebel Alliance.
Katniss Everdeen is a symbol, a mockingjay. They think she's one of them. We need to show that she's one of us.
Not only is he a part of the Rebel Alliance, he's actually orchestrating the start of the rebellion right under Snow's nose. Snow's paranoia and fear make him blind to this. The only time that Snow shows any affection, happiness, or peace is when he's with his granddaughter.
Your hair looks lovely, darling. When did you start wearing it like that?
Everyone at school wears it like this now, Grandpa.
She's not a character that we see in the book, so we don't actually get to see their interactions. But these interactions are so crucial. They show that Snow is a human. He is capable of love. He's capable of being kind. He's capable of being happy. He's an extremely loving and caring grandfather. He's just also a horrible dictator.
We both know I'm not above killing children, but I'm not wasteful.
Do you like Snow's character? Please tell me in the comment section down below. And until next time, happy bubbles! If you want to see any of my other videos, you can click on the box on the left to find out if Seneca Crane was actually a rebel, or you can click on the box on the right to find out what would have happened had this rebellion failed. Please leave a like if you enjoyed this video, and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos!